under the DG, the NYSC has effectively flushed out fake graduates from participating in this scheme. This he achieved through rigorous screening and monitoring. There's also been tremendous infrastructural development in the last 1 year, from the ongoing construction of ICT centers at the headquarters to the completion and equipping of Kaduna NYSC printing press. Major General Ibrahim has improved revenue generation. Funds generated have been plunged into the nation's treasury, a proof that the NYSC, if properly administered, Nigeria is set to overcome some of its financial challenges.
All of you know why we are doing NYSC. Most of you don't know. Nigeria at a particular time had a civil war. Eastern State, blah, 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 there was Biafra story. But when the war finished, General Gawan said, no vanquished, and of course, no winner, no vanquished. So how to now consolidate Nigeria? He said the youth should be moved from their places to serve in other places. I wrote a book for NYSC, the title is NYSC in the Fourth Decade. And I selected five powerful Fayo Saim. Anybody knows him?
Yes.
He was a bloody copper. He served, he's from Ebonyi, he served in Sokoto. He said he didn't want to go to Sokoto because of flies, crocodile and all that. But the Oku said, don't worry, they are going to serve there. It was while serving in Sokoto that met those who made him a senator and senior president. 30 years back. He's from Edo State, he studied in America. He was posted to Bauchi. When he was posted, everybody in Edo, they were crying, he's going to meet people will kill him, Boko Haram, Islam. So he went. God is a very terrible chap, even if you understand English. As Sheda Bauchi, he was going to meet his wife. He went there, met a beautiful lady, a brown lady, they served together, they were married. Today they have 4 children. Remember that NYSC, and Amatadi will tell you, if a corps can find another corps to marry, NYSC is to sponsor them. The policy is still on for national development. Somebody climbing and join. You're already there. Somebody climb and come to join you. Akumbani. They also in the court, Takasa, blah, blah. So, we've all served. I can tell you I'm a proud youth copper, proud grandfather of copper. But I also want to tell you, and I'm not here, I'll tell you, but I had tried to say that it will not happen. The idea, I will say that of my class, if you are still laughing, the idea that powerful people like myself will fix their children to stop. Let the daughter of Muhammad Buhari go and serve at Ajegunle, so I can know the sufferings of people. Let the daughter of the who and who, but it is not happening. Please, sir, let it continue. I tried it. This is what fixing it now. You cannot change it. 10 years ago, I just make a call to my friends, and then they will change anybody. But I also stop because we want national development.
First, let me congratulate him on his decoration today, his new rank. It's a promotion well deserved. He's one of the finest officers that you can find in the Nigerian Army of today. I've met him twice, and he comes across as a Nigerian in the true sense of the word. In fact, we held a training session for NYC members at our Luke Stella Leadership Foundation, and he was notified. He was not actually invited, but he was only notified that Luke, one of your children will be coming to our facility for training. And lo and behold, Jerry Bryan volunteered to attend the opening session of that training. And he drove all the way to Apple, attended because he placed a lot of premium on the theme of the training, which is social justice, citizenship education, nation building, integration, and conflict resolution. So These are things that this general is very proud and passionate about. And so you have to be there to give his physical support to what we're doing to youth commitments. And that struck a chord with people like us who similarly share the passion for United Nigeria. And so he has finished very strong on this assignment, because I'm aware that at the end of now, maybe he might, as a matter of necessity, be moving on to higher responsibilities. He has revitalized NYSC. NYSC today is being run with the efficiency you find in the private sector. I say this because I have a lot of experience. NYSC is no longer that agency where anything goes. In fact, I will tell you this. Somebody actually put pressure on us to get the NYSC to bend its rules for a particular candidate who was a child of a highly placed Nigerian. Well, to my pleasure and to the disappointment of the person in question, nothing of such happened. No. I'm talking about a recent development.
My name is Omotade Ayodele Foronsho, and I'm Vice Grace Director in charge of Core Welfare and Health Services of the National Youth Service Corps. Here representing the Director of NYSC, Major General Shoaibu Ibrahim, the Director of NYSC. The future of our nation, Nigeria, belongs in the hands of the youth. Himself happened to be a youth. It's a symbol of youth, representative of youth. And from the resume that has been read to our hearing, he was at one time a military assistant. In other words, he started preparing himself for this leadership position right from when he was just at the back, watching over the shoulder of his boss in the NYSC. I must also say that Professor Ibrahim, or Major General Ibrahim Shoaibu, if you like to call him that, is a man that believes in excellence in everything he does. And little wonder, very many organizations, individuals have been bestowing on him awards upon awards, even since the beginning of his tenure in NYSC. Here is a man that got into NYSC, caused himself coronavirus TB because of the happenstance occurring at the time when all other administrators who were not prepared to serve would have found their refuge under complaints and, of course, debilitating challenges that would have prevented him from a rendering service. In spite of the coronavirus challenge, in fact, the best was brought out of Professor Shoaibu and Major General Shoaibu. Within that period alone, we are talking of 2 years in service of the NYSC. A lot of transformations are taking place. We thank God for the memory lane that our father, the Reverend Professor Lafulani, has taken us into. But I can make bold to say, without due sense of responsibility, that the NYSC that we are having now is not the same NYSC that we are having in the old days. The challenges are more. The environment has changed totally. The issues and other things that are competing with good performance and good governance of a scheme that is unique like NYSC are all changed. But here we have a man who is determined to make a change. I must instantly tell all of us that organizations, yes, like human beings, they are there to render service. They are alive, they listen, they have feelings, they can die, they can live, they can grow. The personality at each point in time, rendering service makes a lot of difference in the life of any organization. And that is why Nigeria is so blessed to have a personality like Major General Ibrahim Shoaibu coming at this point. I must say that it's a godsend and it's a God arrangement that he will be at the saddle at this time. Believe you me, if it happened to be somebody who is not passionate about Nigeria, who is not passionate about public administration, who is not passionate about public service, we will be thinking or probably forgotten about the burial of the scheme called NYSC. And that is why it amuses me when people are calling, for the scrapping of the scheme. I must also let this audience know that personalities that have spoken here, they have spoken as if they work with NYSC. And one thing that gladdens one's heart is the fact that when outsiders, not outsiders in the sense of it, they are all stakeholders, we are NYC, is the NYC project, and we are all stakeholders in it. But when people that are not directly related to the administration of the scheme speaks like this in favor of a scheme that is so unique like NYSC, we have every reason to give glory to God Almighty. And for us in NYC to encourage that indeed we have a future for this nation. For those who have the mind or the notion that NYC will cry and scrap, of course, we will not take it against them. Organizations evolve over time. And I must let you know that yes, there are challenges, but the personality of the man that we are celebrating today has brought a lot of innovations in the NYSC scheme. Only during his administration alone, as has been read in his speech by the Deputy Secretary, we learned about very many giant strides, the issue of sanitizing the deployment process of NYSC, so much that it's apparently very difficult for any non-graduate to come and say they want to participate in NYSC.